The new Mars rover Curiosity is about the size of a small SUV and brings to Mars a collection of 10 scientific instruments, plus an array of other instruments, tools, electronics, communications, and power supply. The arm is 7 feet long with joints, kind of like a shoulder, elbow, and wrist. At the end of the arm is a turret that can hold various tools, like a percussion hammer, scoop, and brush device, and can spin them through a 360-degree range. It is 10 feet long and 9 feet wide. It is 2 times as long and 5 times as heavy as Spirit and Opportunity. It is too heavy and big to land with airbags like Spirit and Opportunity did in 2004. Instead, it lands using descent thrusters and guided by ground-sensing radar. The Mars Descent Imager, or MARDI, is a fixed-focus color camera, fixed-body mounted to the front port side of Curiosity, pointing down and even with the rover's chassis. MARDI will start recording high-resolution video about 2 minutes before landing on Mars. Initially, the camera will glimpse the heat shield falling away from beneath the rover, revealing the Martian terrain below. The first scenes will cover the ground several kilometers or a few miles across. The image will spin, then shake as the rover's parachute, then its rocket-powered backpack, slow the rover's descent. The left front wheel will pop into view when Curiosity extends its mobility and landing gear. Knowing the location of loose debris, boulders, cliffs, and other features will be important in planning the routes Curiosity will take after landing on Mars. MARDI will take color video, a first for Mars exploration, during the rover's descent toward the surface. As soon as the rover releases its heat shield, the Mars Descent Imager will begin producing a 5 frames per second video stream of high-resolution overhead views of the landing site. It will continue acquiring images until the rover lands, at which time it will turn off. The video information and other data won't be available immediately, however, as data will be sent to Earth via relay by 1 or 2 Mars orbiters. So the daily data volume will be limited by the amount of time the orbiters are overhead each day. MEDLI, or Mars Science Laboratory Entry, Descent, and Landing Instrumentation, isn't one of Curiosity's 10 scientific instruments, but it is an integral part of the science of the Curiosity rover. It is built into the heat shield that protects the rover on its descent through the Martian atmosphere. MEDLI will collect engineering data during the spacecraft's last 8 minutes of high-speed, extremely hot entry into the Martian atmosphere. It is predicted that heat levels will be about 3 times higher than those of the space shuttle when it entered Earth's atmosphere. This information will tell engineers how well the heat shield performed. MEDLI is actually composed of 2 parts, MISP and MEADS. When the spacecraft faces extreme heat during entry into the Martian atmosphere, MISP will measure how hot it gets at different depths in the spacecraft's heat shield material. MEADS will measure the atmospheric pressure on the heat shield during entry and descent. The MEADS pressure sensors are arranged in a special cross pattern in the heat shield. This cross pattern will also allow engineers to determine the spacecraft's orientation. Researchers can use MEDLI data to improve designs for future Mars-bound spacecraft. A lot of people wonder why the Curiosity rover doesn't have any solar panels, like the Mars rovers Spirit and Opportunity. Spirit and Opportunity often found themselves short on power as dust settled on the solar panels. This was especially a problem during the short days of winter. NASA needed a good, strong, reliable source of power to keep the Curiosity rover going for 2 years on Mars. Curiosity is 2 times bigger, 5 times heavier, and has 15 times the weight of scientific equipment as Spirit and Opportunity. Samples collected while roving over the Martian surface are delivered to some very sophisticated and power-hungry analytical laboratories on board. That's where the MMRTG comes in. The multi-mission radioisotope thermoelectric generator is a power source that has been in use for years to power spacecraft that have gone to the outer planets, and even the Apollo missions used it on the moon. The MMRTG is located on the back of the rover. The generator contains a specially produced form of plutonium dioxide. The natural decay of this isotope gives off heat, which thermocouples turn into electricity. The generator provides both electrical power and heat to the rover. About 100 watts of electrical power is used to continuously charge the rover's batteries. Also, heat can be pumped off of the generator using pipes to keep the rover's insides warm, including the scientific instruments. Curiosity's generator will keep its batteries charged year-round in all sorts of conditions. The Rover Environmental Monitoring Station, or REMS, provided by the Spanish government, is a tool which sits partway up Curiosity's mast and is a Martian weather station. REMS will measure and provide daily and seasonal reports on atmospheric pressure, humidity, ultraviolet radiation at the Martian surface, wind speed and direction, air temperature, and ground temperature around the rover. Two small booms on the rover mast will record wind speed to characterize airflow near the Martian surface from breezes, dust devils, and dust storms. A sensor inside the rover's electronic box will be exposed to the atmosphere through a small opening and will measure changes in air pressure. A suite of infrared sensors on one of the booms, boom one, will measure the intensity of infrared radiation emitted by the ground, which will provide an estimate of ground temperature. A sensor on the other boom, boom two, will track atmospheric humidity. Both booms will carry sensors for measuring air temperature. An array of detectors on the rover deck that are sensitive to specific frequencies of sunlight will measure ultraviolet radiation at the Martian surface and correlate it with other changes in the environment. All of this information will allow scientists to get a detailed look at the Martian environment. Mounted high on Curiosity's mast, extending upward from the Curiosity rover's body, is the mast camera, or MastCam. MastCam will use a side-by-side pair of cameras for examining terrain around the rover. MastCam is actually comprised of two cameras, MastCam 100, a 100mm focal length camera offering telephoto capability, and MastCam 34, offering a wider angle view. Each can provide color images and high definition video, and they can be combined for stereo views. They are both scientific and natural color imaging systems. MastCam 100, the telephoto camera, is referred to as the right eye because of its position on the mast, and MastCam 34 is referred to as the left eye. The right eye MastCam 100 looks through a telephoto lens, revealing details near and far with about threefold better resolution than any previous land viewing camera on the surface of Mars. MastCam 100 provides enough resolution to distinguish a basketball from a football at a distance of 7 football fields. The chemistry and camera instrument, or ChemCam, is probably the coolest instrument aboard the rover. It fires pulses of a laser at a target such as a rock. Energy from the laser excites a pinhead-sized spot on the target into glowing ionized gas called plasma. Spectrometers in the instrument analyze the spectrum of light emitted by the plasma to identify chemical elements in the target. Different elements glow at different wavelengths or colors. The technique is called laser-induced breakdown spectroscopy. There are two parts of the ChemCam instrument. First is the body unit, which goes inside the body of the rover and contains three spectrographs for analyzing the ionized gas. The other is located on the mast and contains the laser, imager, and telescope. An optical fiber from the mast unit delivers the telescope's observations to the body unit. This image shows a ball of luminous plasma erupting from the surface of an iron pyrite crystal in the testing chamber. The laser beam itself is invisible. The instrument's camera is called the remote microimager. It photographed this dollar bill from 10 feet away. The instrument can fire a laser at Martian rocks up to 30 feet away and analyze the composition of the vaporized bits. ChemCam enables Curiosity to study rocks that are out of the reach of its flexible robotic arm. Provided by the Russian Federal Space Agency, the Dynamic Albedo of Neutrons, or DAN, will check for water-bearing minerals in the ground beneath the rover. Dan is located near the back of Curiosity's main body and has two major components: a pulsing neutron generator on the starboard side of the rover, and the detector and electronic module on the port side. It will help the rover search for ice and waterlogged minerals beneath the Martian surface. The instrument will fire beams of neutrons at the ground, then note the speed at which these particles travel when they bounce back. Hydrogen atoms tend to slow neutrons down, so an abundance of slower neutrons would signal underground water or ice. Dan should be able to map out water concentrations as low as 0.1% at depths of up to 6 feet. The Radiation Assessment Detector, or RAD, is one of the first instruments sent to Mars specifically to prepare for future human exploration. A joint collaboration with Germany's National Aerospace Research Center, it is the size of a small toaster. RAD measures and identifies all high-energy radiation on the Martian surface, such as protons, energetic ions of various elements, neutrons, and gamma rays. The instrument's telescope faces upward from a position near the front left corner of Curiosity's deck. Two kinds of detectors in the instrument monitor charged particles. A third type detects neutral particles. This includes direct radiation from space, the sun, from distant supernovas, other natural sources, and also secondary radiation. A stack of paper-thin silicone detectors and a small block of cesium iodide measure high-energy charged particles coming through the Martian atmosphere. To help prepare for future human exploration, RAD collects data that will allow scientists to determine any harmful effects radiation would have on astronauts on a mission to Mars. The Sample Analysis at Mars instrument, or SAM, is the largest of Curiosity's 10 scientific instruments. It is actually a suite of separate instruments about the size of a microwave oven. It takes up more than half of the science payload aboard Curiosity and features chemical equipment found in many scientific laboratories on Earth. It consists of a mass spectrometer, a gas chromatograph, and a laser spectrometer. SAM is an automated mobile laboratory that is carried across Mars by the rover. These instruments search for methane and carbon-containing compounds, the building blocks of life as we know it. They also look for other elements associated with life on Earth, such as hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. SAM will help assess whether Mars ever was, or is still today, an environment capable of supporting microbial life. The SAM instruments are located inside the body of the rover. The rover's robotic arm will drop samples into SAM via inlet tubes on the top of rover's deck. Some samples will come from deep inside rocks, bored out by a drill situated at the end of the robotic arm, or scooped up from soil. Samples will be delivered to two separate ovens, which will heat the samples to about 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. SAM will also take atmospheric samples through separate ports on the side of the rover. The Chemistry and Mineralogy Instrument, or ChemMin, will identify and measure the abundance of various minerals on Mars. This will help scientists better understand past environmental conditions on the Red Planet. Like SAM, ChemMin has an inlet on Curiosity's deck to accept samples delivered by the rover's robotic arm. Curiosity will drill into rocks, collect the resulting fine powder, and deliver it to a sample holder. It will also use the scoop for collecting soil. Unlike SAM, ChemMin will then direct a beam of X-rays as fine as a human hair through the powdered material, identifying minerals' crystalline structures based on how the X-rays diffract. Different minerals are linked to certain kinds of environments. Scientists will use ChemMin to search for mineral clues indicative of a past Martian environment that may have supported life. Located on the end of the robotic arm is the Mars Hand Lens Imager, or MALI. MALI's main job is to acquire color close-up images of rocks and surface materials in Curiosity's landing area. The MALI Adjustable Focus Color Camera is one of the tools on the turret end of Curiosity's robotic arm. A human geologist uses a handheld lens to help identify minerals in rocks. On the rover, Molly will provide scientists with close-up views of minerals, textures, and structures of Martian rocks. The camera takes color images of features smaller than a human hair. Its focal length can be adjusted to photograph more distant objects from any positioning of the rover's long arm. Molly carries white light sources and ultraviolet light sources, allowing it to function during the day or night. It is important, even on Earth, to understand the scale of an object being photographed. So a well-known object is usually placed in the photograph. Molly will use a special Lincoln penny as one of its reference targets. The Lincoln penny is a 1909 VBD penny, minted the first year pennies were minted. The calibration reference aboard Molly is called the calibration target. It is a plaque about the size of a smartphone and includes the penny and two other calibration targets. The calibration plaque is attached to a shoulder joint of the arm. In addition to the penny, two other calibration targets are used. First, six patches of pigmented silicone, guiding interpretation of color and brightness, and a marked scale of black bars. This will not appear in the photos, but will aid in determining the distance from the camera to a rock and allow scientists to correlate calibration images. If cameras are Curiosity's eyes, then the onboard spectrometers make up the rover's nose. The spectrometers will sniff out the chemical composition of rocks and soil. Provided by the Canadian government, the Alpha Particle X-ray Spectrometer, or APEX, sits at the end of Curiosity's arm, while the main electronics are back inside the body of the rover. It will determine precisely what elements are present in a given sample of Martian rocks and dirt. Curiosity will place the instrument in contact with samples of interest, and APEX will shoot out X-rays and helium nuclei. APEX will rely on two techniques to do this: particle-induced X-ray emission, or PIXE, and X-ray fluorescence, XRF. PIXE relies on the fact that fast-moving alpha particles can knock electrons from the lowest energy level of atoms right out of the atom itself. This leaves an atom with an unstable configuration of electrons, and one of the electrons in the high energy levels of the atom will now drop down to the low-level one, emitting an X-ray as it does so. APEX has a detector to capture these X-rays, and we can determine the elements in the sample by looking at the energy of those X-rays. Each element emits X-rays with very specific energies. APEX contains curium-244 as a source of alpha particles, but it also decays into plutonium-240, which emits X-rays, which in turn can excite X-ray emissions in other atoms. This is called X-ray fluorescence, and the idea is pretty much the same as PIXE, except that instead of alpha particles causing the excitation, this time it is X-rays. The two methods turn out to be very complementary, as X-ray fluorescence is good for detecting heavier elements as opposed to PIXE's detection of the higher elements. Spirit and Opportunity were outfitted with a previous version of APEX and used the instrument to help make clear the prominent role water has played in the shaping of the Martian landscape. The instruments, science, tools, electronics, communications, and power supply of Curiosity make it the most complex and comprehensive explorer ever sent to the Red Planet.